Yes. The good news is I don't think it's going to be a widespread event this morning, but as we're heading towards late morning, into this afternoon, it will become widespread across the area. So where you may be able to get out now here for the short-term hit or miss areas that may be slick, as we're moving through today, I do expect conditions to deteriorate for everyone across our viewing area. And you can see that cloud cover is thick, the drizzle is patchy across the area this morning, and we do have bona fide freezing rain pushing into our viewing area this morning. Freezing rain because everybody is well below freezing in the 20s, so as that rain falls, once it reaches the ground, anything elevated, untreated, it will likely freeze on contact this morning. And this winter storm, a huge impact for many across the country. We're talking about Oklahoma City through Springfield, Lake of the Ozarks, Columbia, Missouri, a major ice storm. We're talking about accumulating ice that will likely knock power out, knock tree limbs down for areas to our south and to our southwest and southeast. Across our viewing area, we're beginning to see that freezing rain push in, especially south and east. And this is where we'll see the heavier amounts of ice accumulations across our viewing area. We're talking about a quarter of an inch of ice for areas of Clinton, Warrensburg through Sedalia, right along I-70 eastbound. And again, we have seen a few reports of a little bit of drizzle, a few light sprinkles from Pleasant Hill through Lee Summit, stretching through Odessa this morning. And it is just a matter of time. This moisture is going to all lift its way to the north and overtake our viewing area as we're moving through the morning and afternoon hours today. So for this morning, I'm going to give you the yellow light. I don't think we're going to have widespread issues here for the next few hours, but again, conditions are going to go downhill pretty quick, I think, as we're heading towards the lunch hour today. If it's untreated this morning, it could be slick. By the lunch hour, through this afternoon, freezing rain and sleet will likely overtake the area, more roads becoming icy. As we're heading towards tonight, this is when the heaviest of this storm will move in. After sunset tonight, freezing rain, sleet, and snow, it could be heavy at times, the worst in terms of travel across our area, I think, between about 7 o'clock tonight and say sunrise tomorrow morning from 7 to 7. Light snow is what you'll wake up to tomorrow morning, but a good snowpack already on the ground. Snow totals of 3 to 6 inches. Ice accumulations of a quarter of an inch, a possibility across our viewing area. And as Jana mentioned, news at KMBC.com. When you tell us what's going on, we pass it along to all of our viewers, all of our cities and our 44 counties. So it's a great way to help stay connected about what's going on and to continue that flow of information with this winter storm. Another great resource. We know you're going to be on the go. Many of you are still going to have those holiday errands that you're going to try to get done, our KMBC 9 News app. Also on Twitter, I'm going to try to send as much information about what's going on, retweet as many reports across the areas as I can this morning. So Erin Little, KMBC, again, that's at Twitter. Here's a look at your future scan, and again, a lot of pink. All of this lifting north by the lunch hour, overtaking the 435 loop and pressing into St. Joe. As we're heading towards your evening plans tonight, not only heavier amounts of freezing rain, but then that transition by, say, sunset tonight to snow. And it could be heavy at times overnight tonight. The snow won't be as heavy by the time you wake up tomorrow morning, but we'll likely have a good snowpack on the ground during the Chiefs game tomorrow. I don't expect additional accumulations, but yes, snow showers are expected off and on for your Sunday. So let's talk about the totals. Right along I-35 is where I expect the heaviest amount, a good 3 to 6 inches, and I wouldn't be surprised if we have a few pockets of heavier than that, a good 7-8 for Chillicothe here in Kansas City, a good 5 to 6 inches of snow expected across the 435 loop. The snow quickly goes downhill for Clinton and Sedalia, but this is where we'll see more ice accumulations, a quarter of an inch of ice to the south and east for tonight. Here's a look at that 7-day forecast. We'll see light snow showers as we're working through your Sunday, and then dangerously cold conditions with the snowpack for Monday. Highs only in the teens for Monday afternoon. And I do think we could see a few light snow showers on Christmas Day. The good news, snowfall on Christmas Day will be very light. It won't be nearly as long in terms of the duration, and I don't expect it to impact travel like we will have this weekend. Yeah.